click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in this video we will study a new chapter called as Visual Basic. What is Visual Basic? Visual Basic is basically a programming language which is used to create a user interface. Unlike C++, Visual Basic has ability to allow us to create a user interface. And Visual Basic is basically called as event-driven programming language. Now what is event-driven programming language? See, the event-driven programming language means the code of the Visual Basic will remain idle unless and until the event doesn't occur. For an example, suppose if I'm filling an online application form. After filling all the details of mine, what I will do next? I have to click on what? I have to click on the submit button. It means what? Unless and until I don't click on the submit button, my form won't get submitted. So this is called as what? Event-driven programming. Event is called, clicking on a button is an event. Suppose if you are dragging a mouse, you are scrolling a mouse, you are dropping a mouse, these are also can be a event. So whenever some event performs, then only your action get performs. Then that's why this is called as event-driven programming language. So let us learn Visual Basic in detail. As in the introduction I said, Visual Basic is an event-driven programming language. It means the code of the Visual Basic will remain idle unless and until the action is not performed. As I gave an example of online form filling application, unless and until I don't click on the submit, my form won't get submitted. So this is called as what? Event-driven programming. There are various tools in the Visual Basic like command button, checkbox, text box, option button, combo box, image box, picture box, and etc. So we have to study every tool in a detail, and we have to study the use of every tool. Now let us start with the features of the Visual Basic. The first feature of Visual Basic says full set of objects so that you can draw your application. As I said, it will allow you to create a user interface. It means what? You can create a user interface with the help of Visual Basic by using those various tools. As I said, we have the text box, we have the label, we have the command button, we have the checkbox. So using those various tools, you can create or you can design your application. That is called as what? Creating a user interface. The number of icons and pictures for your use, again the same thing, there are a number of icons and pictures which you can display on your form. Response to a mouse and keyboard action, that's why it is called as event driven programming. It responds to the event which occurs. Next is a clipboard and printer access. Yes, it gives you a direct printer access. Then full set of mathematical and string handling function. There are some mathematical and string handling function, like there are some inbuilt mathematical and string handling function. Powerful database access tool. With the help of Visual Basic, you can configure your Visual Basic to the various powerful database access tools and ActiveX support. So these are the various features of Visual Basic. Now here there is a list of the elements of the toolbox. We have the picture box, then we have the label, we have text box, frame, command button, checkbox, option button, combo box, list box, scroll bar, shape, line, image, data, and so on. Now see, number one is picture box. Why the picture box is used? Picture box is basically used to display a picture or to display an image. Label is a tool which is non-editable at the runtime. So it is basically used to display only a label. Now suppose if I'm filling an online application form, then you must have seen your form looks something like this. Here there will be a caption called as name, and in front of name there will be a blank space. So the caption where your name is displayed, this is called as what? Label, which is non-editable. You cannot edit that caption which is written on the label. So that's why this is called as non-editable. Whereas in the text box you can edit something, in the text box you can enter something. So the next is text box. Then you have the frame. In the frame is basically used in the designing purpose, or basically used to divide your form into various sections. Then we have the command button. Command button is the most important tool, because when we click on something, then only your form gets submitted. So that is called as what? Your command button. Then checkbox. Checkbox is to select the multiple options from the list. If you want to select the suppose list of the subjects, if they have given, and if you want to select the multiple subjects, then basically one kind of tool comes where you can just click on it. When you'll click on it, the right tick appears, and this tool is called as what? Checkbox. Then we have the option button. Unlike checkbox, in the checkbox you can select the multiple options, but in the option button you can select any one. So option button is basically used to select any one from the group of items or from the group of elements. Then we have the combo box. The combo box is a drop down list which comes when we select the items from the list box. So list box and combo box both are same, only combo box is editable, list box is non-editable. Combo box looks something like this. The one arrow comes, and when I click on the arrow, the one drop down list comes. From that drop down list, you can select the multiple options. Then we have the horizontal and vertical scroll bar. This is basically used to scroll the form. Then we have the shape. With the help of the shape, you can draw the various shapes like rectangle, circle, and so on. Then lines are used to draw lines. Image is same as a picture box. In the image box also, you can upload the images. So these are the various elements of toolbox. The most commonly used elements of toolbox are label, text box, command button. As in the 11th standard, you don't have much about the Visual Basic, you just have to draw the basic forms. So you have the basic tools only to be used in the program. Next is, every tool has some properties. So these are the some of the common properties which we use, like name, appearance, back color, fore color, font, caption, text, width, height, and enabled. Name is to change the name of the tool. Then appearance, 0 for flat and 1 for 3D. Then you can change the back color, full color, you can change the font, you can change the caption, text, width, height of the various tools. Now see, here we will discuss the properties of some important tools. So let us start with the label. We change the name and caption property of the label. So by default, your label will be having a name called as label 1. But you can change the name of the label, and when we change the name of the label, we use the abbreviation, that is LBL. So you can change the name of the label by putting the abbreviation LBL, and after that any name you can give to the label. And the caption is basically used to display the caption. Now suppose if I have taken one label, and on that label if I want to display a name as a caption, then your caption property will be set to what? Name. And the name property is to change the name of the label. So by default name is going to be a label 1. You can make it as LBL name. Then next is a text box. Text box has the properties again name and text. Text property we use when we want to enter something into the text box, or we want to change the text of the text box, whereas the name of the name property is used to change the name of the text box. Whenever we change the name of the text box, we use the abbreviation called as TXT. So to change the name of the text box, you cannot directly change the name of the text box, you have to use the abbreviation TXT. Then there is the next tool called as command button. Command button again has the properties name and caption. To change the name of the command button, we use CMD. So first we write CMD and then we give the name to the command button. And caption property is used to change the caption of the command button. So like this, we have the various tools like list box. To change the name of the list box, we use LST. To change the name of the combo box, we use the CMB. To change the name of the option button, we use OPT. To change the name of the checkbox, we use the CHK. So these are the various abbreviations we use while changing the name of the various tools. Then to change the name of the various tools. Now hope you have understood the features of the Visual Basic, and you have understood what are the common tools or the common elements which we use while drawing a Visual Basic application. And then we saw what are the few common properties which we use while dealing with the elements of the toolbox. Thanks for watching the video. In the next video, we will see the programming of Visual Basic.